I got a MISA S3D printer from the company G-Tech. With the dimensions 36x38x72cm, the filament printer is quite compact. The frame is made of extruded aluminum measuring 20x20 and 20x40mm. The electronic components are in the metal box that covers the base of the printer. The package includes the tools needed for the assembly, replacing the 0.4mm nozzle or adjusting the mechanics. The short assembly instruction is included as a printed and a digital version, the latter is on the microSD card. The MISA S is delivered almost completely assembled, only the frame has to be mounted on the base, and the spool holder has to be attached on the top of the frame. High resolution photos of the package contents. The assembly. And the whole printer are available on the website of How Open Is This Gadget. The electronic components inside the base are arranged properly. The power supply has an output voltage of 24V at up to 14.6 amps, which corresponds to 350 watts. The color touchscreen has a resolution of 480x320 pixels. An STM32F microprocessor is placed on the mainboard, running the open source firmware Marlin. The stepper motor drivers type TCM2208 are soldered to the circuit board. The MISA S has a Bowden extruder. The extruder motor is located on the left of the X-axis and pushes the filament towards the hot end with a gear reduction of 3 to 1. The hot end is also well designed and can be easily disassembled if necessary. There is a force sensor for leveling the print bed on the mount of the hot end, which can be seen at the top of the heatsink. Inside the filament sensor is a tiny, easy to trigger mechanical switch. With that, feeding the filament is done quickly. The axes are guided along extruded aluminum by plastic rollers with ball bearings. Backlash can be eliminated simply by turning an eccentric nut. The belt tension of the X and Y axes can be easily adjusted via small hand wheels. With that, the adjustment of the mechanics is done. If set up correctly, all axes run smoothly. The maximum print volume is 255x255x260mm. The MISA S has limit switches for both Z-axis stepper motors. The motors can be controlled independently so that adjusting the X-axis in parallel to the print bed is not needed, this is done by the firmware. To level the print bed, the force sensor must first be triggered manually using one of the wrenches. After that, the firmware takes over and measures the height of the print bed at 9 points. There are no adjusting screws on the print bed, manual leveling is not necessary, but also not possible. Finally, the set height is adjusted so that only a sheet of paper fits tightly between nozzle and print bed. The heated print bed reaches 100 degrees Celsius after 10 minutes and 110 degrees Celsius after 15 minutes, which is the maximum temperature. The build plate is a plastic coated steel plate that magnetically sticks to the bed, making it easy to remove the prints. With all fans and motors running, the MISA S sounds like this. let's do some test prints. I use a spool of PLA which I received from G-Tech as an extra along with the printer. As a first test I check the level function. 16 discs, each with a diameter of 50mm, are printed across the build plate. The layer height is 0.2mm, the print speed is set to 15mm per second. All discs stick well to the print bed. More about the test procedure and high resolution photos of the results are available on the website. The next test is the obligatory Benji. All information about the print settings used and photos of the results are also on the website. This video shows the printing process in moving pictures with a soundtrack. Open your ears and eyes to judge for yourself. After about 2 hours, the Benji is done with a print speed of 30mm per second. The second Benji is printed with 60mm per second. And done after 1 hour. The third Benji is printed with 90mm per second. Resulting in just 43 minutes of print time. Benji number 3 is printed at 120mm per second and even higher acceleration, which is definitely outside the manufacturer's recommended values. but in principle, it's still possible to print the Banshee that fast. In order to print large objects quickly, as much plastic as possible must be extruded per time unit, which is tested here. Until the limit is obviously exceeded. Again, the website provides all the numbers and background information on the test procedure. As a final test, the largest 3D Banshee that fits on the build plate is printed with the maximum material throughput found to be good in the previous test. This video showed you the Misa S in moving pictures and with the sound emitted by this printer for people with eyes and ears for the details. How open the Misa S from GTEC is, all information about the test procedures and high resolution photos of the device, its inner components and the test prints can be found on the website of How Open Is This Gadget. With that you can get your own impression of the printer, without anyone babbling of what you should think about it. Thanks for watching and I'll be back.